Mr. Romney, where do you stand on reform for the current lobbyist situation we have in Washington?
I personally believe that when campaigns spend the kind of money they're now spending, this race, I understand Ted Kennedy will spend about $10 million to be reelected. He's been in 32 years, $10 million. I think that's wrong because, and that's not his own money. That's all from other people. And to get that kind of money, you've got to cozy up as an incumbent to all of the special interest groups who can go out and raise money for you from their members. And that kind of relationship has an influence on the way you're going to vote. But these kinds of associations between money and politics, in my view, are wrong.
I don't have lobbyists running my campaign. I don't have lobbyists that are tied to my...
That's not true, Governor. That is not true. Ron Kaufman is a lobbyist. He is one of your senior advisors.
He's an advisor. I'm appreciative that you think that's funny, but Ron Kaufman is not even in on the senior strategy meetings of our campaign. So we don't have him in it.
Who does have lobbyists running their campaign by that definition?
Excuse me, Glenn.
Was he in debate sessions at all? Anytime? He's never.
At any time? Has he ever been in a debate session? Sure. Is that a senior strategy meeting?
Is that a senior strategy meeting of our campaign?
One more question, then we have to
He's not running my campaign. He's not running my campaign. He's not running my campaign.
There's another law.
Listen to my words. What? Listen to my words.
I
don't have lobbyists running my campaign. I don't have lobbyists that are tied to my...
True.
I don't have lobbyists that are tied That's
to not
my...
true, Governor. That is not true.
My words.
What?
Listen to my words.
That's semantics. Running your campaign
that
and
is
giving you
word.
Advice? Come on. He's on the plane.
Hey, Glenn, save your argument.
And which is something which I think this country needs. I want universal coverage. I want everyone in Massachusetts and in this country to have insurance. Where are we going with universal health care? I support universal health care.
Because you paved the way for health care reform in Massachusetts, we were able to pass the Affordable Care Act, Obamacare.
We took that on in Massachusetts. We decided we wanted to get everybody insured. We've done that. I understand that the president considers his plan in some respects following the model of Massachusetts.
And I hope we're ultimately able to eliminate some of the differences, repeal the bad, and keep the good.
I will be able to point out that what he did was wrong. It was bad medicine. It's bad for the economy, and I will repeal it.
I'm listening to you, Mitt, and I'm hearing you say all the right things, but I read your first book, and it said in there that your mandate in Massachusetts, which should be the model for the country. And you can get up and talk about, I'm against it now, and I'm going to rescind Obamacare, I'm going to repeal Obamacare, but the record is very clear. You and Newt were for individual mandates. Who can stand on the stage, look Obama in the eye, and say Obamacare is an abomination for this country?
You've got a governor who's running for president right now who instituted the exact same thing in Massachusetts.
I'm just saying, you were for individual mandates, my friend.
You look at Wyden-Bennett. That's a health care plan that a number of Republicans think is a very good health care plan, one that we support. Take a look at that one.
Wyden-Bennett would cover everybody. We have an individual mandate, and we think that's the way to go.
No, I like mandates. The mandates
good,
work.
Beg your pardon?
I didn't know you were going to admit that. No, absolutely.
You like mandates.
Let me tell you what kind of mandates I like, Fred, which is this.
If the ones you come up with.
You've got to shut off criminal activity as a way of life. They have to see that the punishments are swift and sure and stiff. I think we have to have longer sentences served. I'm in favor of mandatory sentences. In too many cases, we have judges concerned about overcrowding and other concerns. I think we have to have more jails, more police.
Are you happy that no bankers have ever been brought to book in terms of being sent to prison?
I'm not going to suggest who should have criminal charges brought against them.
I mean, there are subpoenas coming against Goldman Sachs, for example.
We'll see what the course of history will be here.
I think we have to have more jails, more police, but we also have to say if someone is carrying a gun, for instance, in the commission of a crime or using a gun, we're going to give them a stiff mandatory sentence.
I'm not going to suggest who should have criminal charges.
We have to make sure that people know they're going to face very severe punishment for using weapons.
We do have tough gun laws in Massachusetts. I support them. I won't chip away at them. I believe they help protect us and provide for our safety.
Now, as governor, I worked closely with the NRA and the Gun Owners Action League to advance legislation that expanded the rights of gun owners in my state.
We do have tough gun laws in Massachusetts. I support them. I won't chip away at them.
We have a vibrant Second Amendment today because of your work defending and protecting it in the courts and in the public arenas and in the ballot box.
Romney retreats on gun control. Romney, who once described himself as a supporter of strong gun laws, is distancing himself from that rhetoric now as he attempts to court the gun owners who make up a significant force in Republican primary politics. In his 94 Senate race, Romney backed two gun control measures strongly opposed by the National Rifle Association and other guns rights groups. Suddenly, Romney decides to run for president and signs up for a lifetime membership in the NRA.
I seek it now. I'd love to have their support. I believe in the right of Americans to bear arms.
How about
arms.
The Brady Bill?
I believe that people ought to be able to have a firearm to protect themselves. I believe in the Second Amendment.
In that case, why did you come out publicly saying that you supported the assault weapons ban and the Brady Bill?
And will you give the microphone back to the guy? How many more questions have you got?
My final question, if you don't understand the intent of the Constitution, how can you be trusted to defend it? And who will defend it from you?
Look, I was an independent during the time of Reagan Bush. I'm not trying to return to Reagan Bush.
The right way for America to proceed when we face the kind of challenges we face is to pursue the strategy which Ronald Reagan pursued when we face the challenges of the last century.
What do you plan to do about Social Security benefits? And you plan to cut them?
Who told you that? That I or any other Republican plans on cutting Social Security benefits? So far as I know, there's only been one president in my memory that cut Medicare or Social Security. President Obama.
But the government, and not just Obama, Republican presidents have been taking out of the Social Security Trust Fund for years. Yes. And so let's have a little light on the subject.
Yeah, let's go back again. No one is talking about restructuring Social Security or Medicare for current retirees or for those that are near retirement. What they're saying...
About
those that are under 55. And in that case, the answer is let's talk about it.
One is to increase the retirement age. That's what they did in Great Britain.
Europe isn't working in Europe. Europe is not going to work here in this country.
Another option is to means test the benefits to some degree. Again, they did a similar thing like that in Great Britain. And then finally, you can say, we're going to raise taxes. I'm not in favor of raising taxes. I think government takes enough from the American people.
We can raise taxes on the people that are under 55. All right? That's one way we could do it. And one is to say we're going to raise the retirement age. Well, that alone we could raise taxes. That's one way.
It's against his principles, but he voted for it anyway. That, in my opinion, is not the kind of leadership we need to have in this country.
I have always opposed abortion, but when I ran for office, I thought, I can say...
I believe that abortion should be safe and legal in this country. I believe that since Roe v. Wade has been the law for 20 years, that we should sustain and support it. And I sustain and support that law and the right of a woman to make that choice.
But I was an avidly pro-life governor. I am a pro-life individual.
With regards to my views, with regards to protecting a woman's right to choose, and I've been very clear on that, I will preserve and protect a woman's right to choose and am devoted and dedicated to honoring my word in that regard. I want the voters to know exactly where I'm going to stand as governor, and that is I am not going to change our pro-choice laws in Massachusetts in any way. I will preserve them, I will protect them, I will enforce them. And therefore, I'm not going to make any changes which would make it more difficult for a woman to make that choice herself.
But I was an avidly pro-life governor.
When he went to Utah and was thinking about running for governor of the state of Utah, he made a point of writing a letter to the editor, to the Utah paper out there, specifically stating he was not pro-choice. And then when he came back to Massachusetts, he's become a passionate supporter of a woman's right to choose. Ted Kennedy said it best, Mitt Romney isn't pro-choice, he's not anti-choice, he's multiple choice.
I don't accept either label, pro-choice or pro-life. Instead, I make it clear that I will preserve and protect a woman's right to choose. I will not use
then
a single
points,
hyphenated word.
I am pro-life.
Pro-choice.
And I think you have to stand on your record, and I think you have to stand on the statements that you've made, and I think you've been running away from those statements.
I've been standing on my record throughout my career.
You don't have a record. It's one of waffling.
I am absolutely committed to my promise to maintain the status quo with regards to laws relating to abortion and choice. So far, I've been able to successfully do that.
After he became pro-life,
He did appoint pro-abortion judges, and a branch of the government, which included his appointees, did agree to fund an abortion clinic for Planned Parenthood. All that occurred after he had become pro-life.
That we can believe as we want, but we will not force our beliefs on others on that matter.
Thank you.
And you will not see me wavering on that.
I'm not willing to sit back and say, too bad for Michigan, too bad for the car industry, too bad for the people who lost their jobs, they're gone forever.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said. My the headline you read, which is said, let Detroit go bankrupt. Gosh, I thought you said they did go into bankruptcy, right? And that's what I said they needed to do.
That these companies need to go through a process of shedding their excess costs, hopefully outside the bankruptcy courts.
The president ultimately did what I suggested.
No, the bailouts were a mistake. I don't like bailouts.
I'm not interested in bailing out individual institutions. No one likes the idea of a Wall Street bailout. I certainly don't.
In 2008 that it prevented the collapse of the financial.
I think there is need for economic stimulus, and government can help make that up in a very difficult time.
I'm convinced that the time of government and spending to solve our problems has passed.
Should the chairman of the Federal Reserve be appointed again?
I think he's doing a good job.
You do?
Yes, I do. The Federal Reserve should have blown the whistle. They should have said, this is a huge problem. Anybody.
The Federal Reserve should have done more.
Yeah.
Then would you like to see somebody new in charge of the Federal Reserve and not Mr. Bernanke?
I'm not saying who I'd appoint to the Federal Reserve, but it's not likely to be the
job,
same. Not likely to be the same person.
What kind of job is Ben Bernanke doing right now? The guy's depreciating the dollar. We're seeing this huge inflation of energy prices, including gasoline prices at the pump. What do you think of Ben Bernanke?
Well, you know, I think Ben Bernanke is a student of monetary policy. But look, I'm not going to spend my time going after Ben Bernanke. I'm not going to take my effort and focus on the Federal Reserve.
You express support for the policies of George Bush and John McCain on immigration.
I think an amnesty program is which is all the illegal immigrants who are here are now citizens, mm-hmm. and walk up and get your citizenship. Registering to become a citizen or applying to become a citizen and paying a fee, and those are things that are being considered, and I think that those are reasonable proposals.
Reasonable proposals.
Mm. Look, amnesty is a magnet. That's going to only encourage more people to come here illegally.
The Lowell Sun, one of your hometown state home papers, said this: Governor Mitt Romney expressed support for an immigration program that places large numbers of legal residents on the path toward citizenship.
My own view is, consistent with what you saw in the Lowell Sun, that those people who have come here illegally should be able to sign up for permanent residency or citizenship.
Well, the answer is self-deportation, which is people decide that they can do better by going home because they can't find work here because they don't have legal documentation to allow them to work here.
I believe stem cell research is important for our state and for our nation. Well, it's a very important topic, which is how you use taxpayer money to fund various forms of research. I have put forward a very broad-based economic stimulus proposal. It's several hundred million dollars, almost $700 million in proposals, and included within it is a sort of capital that could go for research, and stem cell research, among others, could be included.
Despite Romney's new pro-life policy stance, he invests personal money in two companies involved with embryonic stem cell research. Romney says that his money's in a blind trust, but when Ted Kennedy used the blind trust defense back in 94, Romney called that a ruse, in other words, a trick.
When we revealed from an article in one of the Boston papers something about your blind trust that appeared not to be quite so blind.
Can you point to an area in which you're changed to a position that is less popular with the Republican base?
Sure. A number. Quite a few, actually. One is No Child Left Behind. I've taken a position where once upon a time I said I wanted to eliminate the Department of Education.
What's happened in education? It's failing us. Look at our scores. Look what's happening to our kids. We have subsidized a behavior that in many respects is killing education and killing our ability to compete.
I see that the Department of Education can actually make a difference. So I supported No Child Left Behind. I still do. I know there are a lot of my party that don't like it.
No Child Left Behind needs to be changed, I think, it's in pretty significant ways before it's reauthorized.
You said without qualification, quote, we need to get the federal government out of education. Governor, on the stump, you criticize Rick Santorum for his answer in a recent debate, taking one for the team. And that was casting his vote for No Child Left Behind. But you have been on that team.
I'm wondering what your position is.
My view has been to allow the minimum wage to rise with the CPI or with another index so that it adjusts automatically over time.
So you'd support that as president?
I've already indicated that when I was governor of Massachusetts, and that was my view.
Why do you want to raise the minimum wage? Why do you want to index it for inflation?
Well, actually, when I was governor, the legislature passed a law raising the minimum wage. I vetoed it. Right now, there's probably not a need to raise the minimum wage.
Mr. Romney, you say you're a moderate on social issues. In fact, you say you will do more to promote gay rights than Senator Kennedy.
You said in 1994 that you looked forward to the day when gays and lesbians could serve, and I quote, openly and honestly in our nation's military. Do you stand by that?
And my view is that at this stage, this is not the time for us to make that kind of a change.
Is that a change in your position from the
I didn't think it would work. I didn't think don't ask, don't tell would work. I didn't think that would work. I thought that was a policy. When I heard about it, I laughed. I said, that didn't make any sense to me. And you know what? It's been there now for, 15 years? It seems to have worked.
So just so I'm clear, at this point, do you still look forward to a day when gays can serve openly in the military or no longer?
I look forward to hearing from the military exactly what they believe is the right way to have the right kind of cohesion and support in our troops, and I'll listen to what they have to say.
All right.
The failures of Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac are just so legion that we really have to rethink about how we're going to support a growing housing industry.
What Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac were doing was simply unsustainable and dangerous to the economy.
But apparently what he thinks is a failure for America is just great for his own personal bank account. The Boston Globe reports Romney has up to $500,000 in mutual fund that invest in Fannie and Freddie.
We have also, what's happened in the area of poverty? The very people we were trying to help with all these programs seem to have been most affected negatively. We've always had poverty in our country, but now people are locked in poverty, can't climb out of it.
I'm not concerned about the very poor. We have a safety net there.
But no question about one thing, it's getting warmer.
Yeah, you got my quote right. And my quote was this: do I think the world's getting hotter? Yeah, I don't know that, but I think it is. But I do not believe in cap and trade. I do not believe in putting a carbon tax on. There are others who think that's the right way to go. I oppose those. And there are other people who would like to put in place a cap and trade program and dramatically increase the cost of energy. That's their view. By the way, that'll kill a lot of jobs.
Now, what happens if we decide to put caps of some kind and targets and so forth? Well, I think one important principle I want to make is this, and that is we don't call it America warming, we call it global warming. And that being the case, I want to make sure that those kinds of discussions are held on a global basis. But we're going to have to work globally to put together a plan to reduce this, if you will, these gases, which very may well be causing dramatic warming of our planet.
I don't know if it's mostly caused by humans. And so what I'm not willing to do is to spend trillions of dollars on something I don't know the answer to.
So as I hear it, you're leaving the door open to possible carbon cap or carbon tax.
Oh, I'm not a man that favors taxes, and so I'm not gonna make a statement of that nature. But I can tell you that I don't close off inquiry and discussion on a lot of topics.
I do not believe in putting a carbon tax on. But I do not believe in cap and trade. I oppose those.
He would not say whether he supports or opposes the specific measures.
I'm not speaking about the particular ballot issues. Those are up to the people of Ohio.
Oh, I'm sorry if I created any confusion in that regard. I fully support Governor Kasich's, I think it's called Question 2 in Ohio.
Dealing with the kind of regulations you deal with, the licensing, the permitting, the local, state, federal regulations can become backbreaking, and we have got to cut through it. We have got to reduce the size of this government gorilla hanging on our backs. That is something we have to do. And we're at a point where we cannot continue, in my view, to keep going down that road that we've been going down for the past 30 years.
But we are a nation of laws, and our freedoms and our liberty are associated with following the law.